Then this is the depicted the diagram of the platform. You can see the platform B1 and also B2. So our project focuses on the both platform we installed with the new facilities. So if you can see that most of the new equipment we install at the B1 platform, inclusive that we install a new flare boom system. So we converting the vent system into the flare system. So we install the flare boom in the second shutdown. So we have two shutdown. So all the major equipment lifting will be performed in shutdown one and also shutdown two. So in between that shutdown two, in shutdown one and shutdown two is the activity construction, testing and commissioning is to be happened within the 45 days period. So this is the enabler that I said in the strategy number two. So what we do is that after the shutdown one, we install the new deck, and then we lifted all the utility system. So we start our strategy to construction, installation of the utility system, and then we perform the testing and commissioning of the utility system. Such as for this in case, we start up our power system, and then we commissioning our new instrument air in utility air package. Okay, next is this is the how we define the work breakdown structure for construction, testing and commissioning. So this project we focus on driven by commissioning. How we want to define our strategy for construction is following the commissioning strategy driven. So we divided into phases so that we perform the pre-shutdown activity and before shutdown September, which is shutdown 2. So the pre-shutdown activity September 21 is the 45 days that we need to complete all the activity within that period. So what we do for field B RFU, you can see in the box below, is that we break down into four main RFU target that we need to achieve. First one is RFIA, ready for instrument air. Phase two RFU is ready for gas in. Phase three is the ready for power migration. And last is RTF, ready to flare. So all the construction activity is following based on this RFU strategy. So we focus on construction of the air system, and then testing and commissioning, and then we're ready for startup, and we move one after another of the phases of the RFU. Next is in terms of technology applied strategy four, installation and construction. The key element that we apply in terms of the installation of this all the equipment is that we perform the machinery survey both at onshore and offshore. And also we perform the onshore trial lift to place all the new equipment on the new deck we install. So we install new deck panel. We remove the existing heli deck, and then we install new deck platform to install all the new equipment on top of the new deck. In order to make sure no problem with this installation offshore, we do trial lift all the equipment we putting on the deck. We trial it onshore, and then we strategize our installation of deck panel and also flare boom in such a way that very easy to install and easy to secure. Next, strategy four. So this is the photo. If you can see that the top two photo is the existing heli deck that we remove. The down below is the new deck that we install. We divide it into two lah. Two part that we install and lift to the platform B1, field platform B1. So what we can do from this strategy that all the equipment laid on the design elevation. So no no rework activity, no leveling required, no modification required. We precisely to put the equipment on the deck, and then provide insurance for the subsequent activity. So after we manage to install it correctly, precisely, so all the activity after that, in terms of commissioning, can be performed accordingly. So after we lift all the equipment, we tie in, we perform the testing and commissioning. So all the activity can be performed timely without any delay. So this is the value impact of the value creation from this project. That you can see that from the strategy, the four strategy that we apply. So there is a four impact creation. First is the completion of startup scope within the period. Even we able to start up earlier than our plan for both shutdown in June and also in July and also in September. We number two is we timely handover prevention of the scope creep and growth. So we make sure that we divided the Barbados structure into the four phases of RSFU. So we able to handover timely. Number three, we able to mitigate risk of the production development throughout the 45 days. So with this strategy, we avoid any unplanned development. So because we strategize our construction, testing and commissioning into part. So this avoid a risk of the unplanned deferment or unplanned shutdown. And also minimal interruption to existing production during the construction and CSU. So there will be a minimum interruption to the existing production activity without the platform need to be shut down. And then the value creation from this applied strategy, we're saving about 34 million production with the strategy of this strategy. We will enable for us to early startup. Number two is the avoidance of the standby cost. With this strategy, we avoidance of standby cost for resources due to the prolonged shutdown duration. Because other contractor and as well as our contractor also execute during the shutdown. So with the shutdown able to complete and perform within the duration, so we avoid any avoiding cost lah. Standby cost of the manpower, equipment, marine spread and many more. So we avoid the cost. And then number three is the instantaneous utilization of power generation after the startup. And this provide we will potential cost saving of portable diesel generator with cost around 200k a year. So with new equipment that we install, diesel generator, diesel engine generator and gas engine generator, this enable for us to avoid any cost for the rental of the portable diesel generator with cost saving of estimated about 200k a year. Okay, next is this is the photo of the all the installed equipment on the B1 platform. So after the shutdown 2, we able to commission testing and pre-commissioning and commissioning of the new flash system, where the startup of the B1 platform by integrating of the all the new equipment that we installed, also converting of the van into flash system. So with the black startup, we able to successfully commission all the equipment and start up the platform smoothly. The photo show also the converting of the van into flash system. So this is the new deck that will install all the equipment. On the new deck, you have the air compressor, diesel generator, gas engine generator, all the utility equipment, vessel, and many more. So the lesson learned, this slide represent in terms of the main lesson learned that we that we encounter from this brownfield project. For us, in order for strategizing a successfully offshore commissioning and startup in a brownfield environment, so this is also the key takeaway that we can utilize. Number one is in terms of the scope definition. So for brownfield project, require a detailed study of the existing facilities in order for us to make sure the smooth migration between the existing and new, especially during the construction, testing, and also commissioning offshore. So by having a comprehensive scope definition, we're able to merge smoothly between the new and also old system. Okay, number two is stakeholder management. So for us, you know, for us to have a better strategize and planning for a brownfield project, we need to get early involvement and participation from the operation team in order for them to provide input, especially in terms of the design as well as for the simultaneous activity. So we will gonna have a lot of parallel activity offshore. We do have a lot of heavy lifting activity at offshore. So by having an input from operation, very benefit for us to strategy our offshore execution. And last but not least is in terms of the planning and resource management. So how we make sure that a detailed plan need to be there. Lah. So we need to develop a detailed planning and also resource management. Resource in terms of the manpower, our equipment and also tools. So we need to develop the strategy and we need to discuss with all the stakeholders on the strategy how to develop the plan. So this is the photo of all our team involved in this project before shutdown in October. So we are this photo taken between all the team inclusive with the operation team. I think that's all from me. Presentation, a paper with a title of strategizing a successful offshore commissioning and startup in a brownfield environment. I think that's all. Thank you very much.